The Robertson Water Treatment Plant is a large part of El Paso's history with water. That history began with the Rio Grande, which supplied the area with water through a system of ditches and canals. The first area waterworks was established in 1882, and the first reservoir was built in Sunset Heights. Pipelines carried water to the main streets. Despite the improvements, residents complained of poor water quality. In the 1890s, the city turned to wells and what were called underground lakes for water. More wells were drilled, and the city continued to grow. El Paso Times librarian Trish Long refers to old newspaper articles that mentioned early concerns about water supply.
In the early 1920s, a group of prominent El Pasoans, which included J.E. Anderson and W.E. Robertson, saw that the need to increase El Paso's water output.
El Paso Mayor J.E. Anderson appointed W.E. Robertson chairman of the Water Development Commission. Robertson predicted a water shortage in 20 years if supplies were limited to wells, so he began actively pursuing river water as an additional source. The Rio Grande project had been established by the U.S. Bureau of Reclamation, and the Elephant Butte Dam and Reservoir were completed. With the completion of the irrigation system, the city had to compete with farmers to acquire water rights. The contract for water rights with the Bureau of Reclamation was signed in February of 1941. At the same time, World War II was underway, and Fort Bliss was expanding with thousands of enlisted soldiers. This meant water demands would continue to rise.
The city went to Washington, D.C. and asked for federal aid to help build the plant. And in December of 1941, they were granted that aid, and it was in the amount of $337,000.
A few months later, Hedman, Ferguson, and Carollo engineers out of Phoenix were hired to design the plant, and R.E. McKee was hired for construction. The plant was designed not only for function, but in the Art Deco architectural style of the period. Ground broke in February of 1942, and Ashley Klassen, superintendent of City Waterworks, described what would be an abundant water supply and several modern processes to create water that would be the purest in the country. The $1 million plant would produce 10 million gallons a day, more than half of what was supplied by the city's 16 wells at the time. It was completed and dedicated in November of 1943 and was named after W.E. Robertson for his efforts to obtain this new water supply for El Paso. At the ceremony, Mayor Anderson said,
"This magnificent plant is for the use of the people of El Paso, not just for a day or a year, but for all time."
The plant was built in one of El Paso's oldest neighborhoods in South El Paso, Chihuahuita. Manuela Rodriguez is a lifelong resident of Chihuahuita. She recalls stories from her father who lived there when the plant was built.
I remember my dad always used to say, progress will always take a bit of the neighborhood, right? And anytime we want to change, you know, that's what's going to happen.
The plant was built on the banks of the Rio Grande near the Franklin Canal. Rodriguez says residents were upset because they no longer had access to what they called a lover's lane along the river, but many understood the plant was needed for El Paso.
It took a chunk of Chihuahuita, it did. But the good thing is, you know, it didn't take all of Chihuahuita.
Rodriguez's father eventually took a job as a laborer at the plant.
We were 10 in the family, and you know, so when he got that job, he was very pleased, he was very happy. We used to make fun of him that he was gonna catch the bus to go to work, you know, cause he would, at lunchtime, he would always be home, he would come in to eat.
She has memories of playing around the plant as a child, going to dinners with other families who worked at the plant, and even taking walks around the area that she continues today.
Anytime we say, do you know where the water treatment plant? That's where Chihuahuita is. We affiliate with that, with the water treatment plant. So to us, it is part of us.
Fred Morales sits on the city's historic landmark commission and has studied Chihuahuita and the plant for decades.
We've always have lived together side by side, and we have a very rich and diverse history.
He says the plant offered an economic advantage for neighborhood residents.
They did welcome it in Chihuahuita. It served as a labor pool also. It employed people from the neighborhood.
The plant proved to be safe and reliable, so in 1949 it was expanded to double its production. As water demands continued to grow, an additional plant was built next door in 1966. It was named after Elwood J. Umbenhauer, who headed El Paso Water Utilities for more than 20 years. The Umbenhauer plant used the same treatment processes as the Robertson plant. Together, the two plants produced 30 million gallons of water a day. Today, the plants produce up to 40 million gallons of water a day. Superintendent Ruben Montes says other than a few technological advancements that allow for more efficient monitoring, the plant works the same as it did 75 years ago.
The process itself really hasn't changed. It's the same process. The water's safe, and that's one of our main goals here, is to provide safe drinking water for the citizens of El Paso.
Montes says the building is old, but because of the care and commitment to maintenance by his employees, he is confident it can serve El Paso for another 75 years.
We get a lot of compliments from people that come here, and either vendors or people that just come to visit. They're impressed by the plant. They say that it doesn't look that old, which is good, because these guys do a great work at keeping it like that.
For President and CEO John Ballou, the plant is close to his heart. Ballou's first job at the utility over 30 years ago was at the plant, where the utility laboratory was located for many years. He agrees the plant has stood the test of time, but what's even more significant is the foresight that was taken to build it.
Right, and I think, again, it's the legacy. So not only what we're doing today, but it's reflective of what happened in the past. In the past, our founding fathers recognized the need to diversify El Paso's water supply, and that is to add a component of water from the Rio Grande to the exclusive Weckable Zone supply that we had. And they saw that way back into the 1920s.
Ballou says the Rio Grande and the plant will continue to be an important part of the utility's water supply strategy now and into the future.
If you take care of a facility like this, it has no expiration date on it. You have to keep it updated. You have to make sure that everything is in working order and repaired. But this structure will be producing water another 50 years, another 75 years from now. We just need to make sure that we have the right team of people who are dedicated and we have the right funding to be able to pay for the needed maintenance and upkeep.
This historic plant has been providing a vital resource to the El Paso community since 1943, and it will continue to for years to come.